There, right, here we go. HP Peppercorn just released today. Blue Peter. Named after the racehorse, not the TV show. Beautiful locomotive. Right. Open the doors and ensure all passengers are back on board. Prepare for the departure at 3:30. Some brakes on here. Don't need the blower at the moment. Mick still shonky. It's turned up as high as it'll go, and the bar is right up to the top. Are you sure it's not just the voice that's shonky? Can't do anything about the voice, I'm afraid. It's kind of stuck with that. Right, so we need to try and... where's my keeper? That's it, that'll do. So I'm watching this now. Watch the steam chest as we apply power so we can get acceleration without wheel slip. Cut the regulator and close cylinder cocks. And a loop for coal. The cam image. Good point. A little trick there. So if you find that you are, I'm just changing the background image. That one, and we'll go for that. There you go. Yeah. So if you find that you are too much power on there, that's better. Now we're off again. So what I'm checking here is the steam gauge here, because this is essentially how much pressure there is on the cylinders. So if that goes too high, then we're going to wheel slip. Right, couple of yes, this loco has AWS. It's meant for running on modern track. There's the AWS there. just edge the cutoff forward a bit so that I can try and keep the cutoff, the boiler pressure balanced. I don't want it to go up too high, but I also want to use it. I want to use that boiler pressure to get the speed up. We've got loads of oil pressure, we can keep the power on. This is nice, the whistle. Right, we're getting there. Let the coal get way too low. That's why the boiler pressure is plummeting. Let's just back off on the power for a minute, let the boiler pressure come back. That'll also let the coal and the water go up a bit faster as well. Hey Georgie, welcome to everyone on the channel. A bit better off when I turn this off. I'm going to get up to water up to 95%, and then it'll the boiler I'll get the boiler pressure back up some more. Better. If I ease off on the power, that's it. The boiler pressure can come back up nice and quickly now. So someone just asked the question, what's the difference between legacy and realistic? So basically, legacy mode does not have a steam chest simulation. You directly control the power on the wheel, which is how it always used to work in the game, whereas the realistic mode has a steam chest, which actually makes it more realistic, but it's also a bit harder. we're up to 90. I'm riding the cut-off quite hard for the purposes of speed, but it is rather having a bad effect on my boiler pressure. Pressure back up, get some more water in. We're over 90. I just saw that signal go yellow a minute ago, so we're coming up on something. It's coal too high. I will slip right at the beginning getting going. A little bit too vicious on the way out. Metro, what tunes? Right, the yellow just went green again. We're getting close to a check though. 93. Back off and get some boiler pressure back at this rate, and water. About to go down a hill anyway, that'll help. Growler asked for a side on look at the loco. There you go. Alright, I've got AWS checks coming up any minute now, I think. Green. Bobber Files keeps asking me, it keeps trying to tempt me to press the HUD button for the whistle, but I'm not falling for it because he knows something I don't. I'm sure he does. Thanks to Scone Empire and Joe742 for following. Much appreciated. Hunting the nut past. Scone Empire. Scone Empire. Flat at the moment, get boiler pressure, get some water in. There's our double yellow. Are we going to get hit? Yep, we're going to get hit. Love that AWS. Will he ever hit 100? I don't know, probably not. Keep needing to back off to let the water come back up. Double amp, double yellow. HUD whistle. I just did. What is that supposed to do? Alright, that's enough water for now. Let's get coal back in. Right, it does. That does as well, it just goes faster. Right, so we're accelerating and building boiler pressure now. That's a bonus. So near platform 3 we're going via. So we're actually stopping at Hitchin. Don't want the blower on at this speed. Please go double. Oh no. This is just bad. That's bad. Double. That's close distance between these signals. the next one. We're back up to doubles, by the looks of it. That's AWS tungsten. So when I go over this ramp here, you'll see hear the AWS go off. Now we're actually two signals. We've got clear blocks between us and what's in front. Realised I left my fridge plugged in. See my USB vanishing shortly if I don't unplug it. I hadn't gone quite as far forward as I thought. Sandy up fast, 1.6 miles, then Big Old Suede, then Hitchin in 13. Right, Sandy up fast, coming in about 30 seconds early. That'll do. Yeah, there was method to my madness. That looked like a nice moment. the steam engine owning the modern train. Eagle Suede, platform 2 is our next waypoint. Just getting some water and some boiler pressure back. About 35 seconds early through Biggleswade. Pitch in 9 miles. Back up. Try and go a bit further forward this time. Cheers, PJT. Phil, thanks for joining. Getting there. 5 miles to go. go, look, 94, and we've got to grow it up on a rising boiler. Well, water tank that's emptying rapidly, but that's a separate problem for another day. Two and a half miles. Two miles. And we've got our 30 limit come up, so I'm going to start backing off on the power now. Double yellow coming up. We're due in to Hitchin in 3 minutes. 1 mile to go. To get down for that 30 limit that's coming up, or as I call it, the point stealer. There we go. Still got just under 2 minutes left. Can afford to come in a little bit leisurely, but not too leisurely. Ed says I'm going to trash his score. What's your score, Ed? Oh, this little crowd here. Boom. Almost exactly on time. .559. Well, I played this once this afternoon. And I got 956. Yeah, that went quite well actually. I'm quite pleased with that. .980. There we go. If I hadn't done that little bit of wheel slip at the beginning, I was so close. Hold on, there'll be a few minutes pause here till our photographs to be taken. I love that scenario. I really do like that scenario. Because you've got this whole balance of trying to get as fast as you can, chasing the double yellow, which, as you saw, nearly went very wrong, and managing all the boiler and doing that whole balancing act. It really is good. Really, really good. Ah, dear. I'd just like to say a really big congratulations and well done to the author of that scenario, who is possibly one of the greatest authors of scenarios I've ever met. There you go. Hopefully he won't poison my coffee in the morning now. Right. Now, what we're going to do now. What we're going to do now is we are going to go to...